1963 Topps Pete Rose rookie card, a hobby trendsetter. In the mid-1980s, you would have been hard-pressed to find a more popular piece of cardboard in the world than the 1963 Topps Pete Rose rookie card. By the time Rose left the Philadelphia Phillies after the 1983 season at age 42, it was pretty clear he was going to be hanging around long enough to break Ty Cobb's record for career hits. The only question at the time was where he was going to play out his career. And it looked like that might happen north of the border when he signed with the Montreal Expos in January of 1984. Fans and collectors yawned or gasped at the news, depending on how closely you followed Rose. And we were all a bit shocked by the sight of Rose in his red, white, and powder blue togs that spring. We braced for the weirdness that would ensue when Charlie Hustle showed up in his Expos uniform that fall and traded in updated sets. Before we even got that far, though, the Cincinnati Reds swooped in and traded Tom Lawless, irony, for Rose and set up one of the most ballyhooed baseball homecomings of all time. Though we may not have realized it at the time, the move also kicked off in earnest the big hobby craze of the 80s, rookie card mania. Not to mention Hume hysteria. Sure, before Rose found his way back home to Riverfront, collectors chased after rookie cards of their favorite players because they wanted to have everything. There was also the general perception that rookie cards in good condition would be the rarest of all the players' cards due to attrition, if nothing else. But when Rose became the Reds player/manager on August 16, 1984, the entire baseball universe coalesced on the idea that the chase was on. Rose would be chasing Cobb's ghost while wearing his hometown Cincinnati red, the same red he bled since childhood. And hobbyists would be chasing Rose cards, all of them, to try to complete their collections before the magical base knock streaked through the Queen City night. Leading the way, of course, was that 1963 rookie card. Like a cardboard clown costume. Visually, the card was striking, if not exactly attractive. As was the case with most rookie cards during the 1960s and 70s, Rose was relegated to a multiplayer card treatment by Topps, who liked to hedge their bets on young, unproven talent. In this case, card number 537 featured a bright yellow background with four tiny circular headshots of, clockwise from top left, second baseman Pedro Gonzalez of the New York Yankees, third baseman Ken McMullen of the Los Angeles Dodgers, shortstop Al Weiss of the Chicago White Sox, and Rose, listed as the second baseman. Each floating head was ironed on over a red background, and a big blue rectangle at the top of the card proclaimed in white block letters that these were 1963 rookie stars. As it turned out, only Rose played regularly in 1963 and hit over 250, though Weiss managed that feat in 99 games, and he was rewarded with the National League Rookie of the Year award. 21 years later, Rose was a clear winner of the four-man lineup, and the rush to pick up his card had pushed his rookie card values to the stratosphere. By Christmas of 1984, collectors and dealers were trying to catch their breaths and make sure they were stockpiled for the 1985 season, when Rose needed a scant 95 hits. To eclipse Cobb. So collectors from Cincy to Philly to Indy to New York to L.A. snatched up all the roses we could find, and the prices for those pasteboards climbed skyward. It was the first time in the modern hobby era that we had an active player gunning for immortality, and a huge number of collectors gunning for his cards at the same time. Collectively, we burned up the card show circuit and kept the hot stove blistering throughout the winter. Who would hit 4,192 first, Rose or his rookie? The Rose rookie traded briskly at around $500 that holiday season, and you were ecstatic if you could scoop one up for less than $400. And back then, we cared about condition, but there was no such thing as graded cards, so we did the best we could. On September 11, 1985, when Rose slapped number 4,192 into the Riverfront outfield and stomped on first base next to smiling Steve Garvey, then with the San Diego Padres, the Rose rookie was closing in on $1,000 in eyeballed mint condition. That moment was the highest point of the Rose hype, but his rookie card and his other issues continued to make steady gains as he led the Reds into strong second-place finishes each year from 1985 to 1988. And then, being the front runner that he is, Rose was at the forefront of the bust that would threaten every aspect of the hobby in the late 1990s and early 2000s. What goes up may go up again. Of course, the downfall of Rose's cards mirrored the downfall of the hero himself, and lifetime banishment for betting on a game that he loved tarnished all aspects of this public persona. Baseball cards were simply along for the ride, and prices fell precipitously. Over the years, however, many fans have softened their stance on Rose, whether due to comparisons with the transgressions of steroid-era players or just thanks to the passage of time. And as more and more of the new generation realized what a great player Rose was on the field, his card prices began to rebound. This was especially true for graded older issues, and naturally the blue, yellow, and red monstrosity led the way again. Love him or hate him, the Cobbuster changed baseball forever. And ugly or not, the 1963 Topps Pete Rose rookie card ushered in a new era of collecting mania and set the stage for much of the hobby explosion to come. Like our video? Then like our video and subscribe to our channel, waxpackgods.com.